Hedging a portfolio against a market correction can be a daunting task, with considerable variables to account for in order to place an effective hedge. In this video, I'm going to teach you how to use index options, such as on the NASDAQ 100, to protect your portfolio with limited risk. Today, we're going to break down two popular hedging strategies to protect a portfolio. But let's first understand why index options are better for hedging over ETF options on the same index. First, there are tax treatment differences. A hedge will typically last only from a few days to a few weeks. With these shorter holding periods, an index option has a potential tax advantage. Index options are Section 1256 contracts, which means that only 40% of your gains are taxed at short-term and 60% is taxed at long-term capital gains. If you were to use an ETF option, a hedge that lasts for less than 1 year would be taxed entirely at short-term capital gains. Additionally, the European settlement nature of index options can benefit hedgers. When you're holding an option contract to expiration, any profits from the hedge will simply be credited to your account in cash, and this would remove any transaction costs associated with exiting the hedge. However, index options historically has had one major disadvantage to ETF options, which is their contract size. Created mostly for institutional investors, index options are generally not accessible for smaller accounts. However, with the launch of XND, the micro NASDAQ 100 index option, you can gain all the advantages of an index option now in a contract size that's even smaller than QQQ ETF options on the same index. Now, let's dive into the strategies that you can use to protect your portfolio against a market correction. Market corrections may seemingly appear out of nowhere, typically caused by a catalyst. But once a market correction starts to occur, let's review two strategies that you can use to protect a portfolio. The simplest of the two strategies would be to buy a put option on an index. In this example, I will use XND, the 1/100th micro index on the NASDAQ 100. With the index at $148 currently, let's review buying a 3-month at-the-money option, the October 148 put for $5.50 debit. The $550 that I would pay per contract would translate to roughly 3.5% of the $15,000 portfolio in order to place this hedge. If the markets continue to move lower after entering this hedge, you will receive unlimited downside protection. But if the markets were to reverse higher, your losses here are limited to just $550 per contract or 3.5% of the entire portfolio. The second strategy is a bit more advanced, but it allows you to buy protection for less, but only protects you for a limited downside. In this example, we will use a put debit vertical spread on XND. With the index currently at $148, let's review buying the same 3-month at-the-money option, the October $148 put for the $5.50 debit. But now we will also sell the October 135 20 delta put for $2.10 credit. This reduces the overall cost of the trade down to $3.40 per share or $340 per contract, which is equivalent of only 2.2% of the $15,000 portfolio. While this strategy is significantly cheaper, you will only receive protection down to the lower strike of $135. It will not provide any additional protection below that. But if the markets were to reverse higher, your losses are now only limited to $340 per contract. In order to buy the right level of protection, you can take your portfolio value and multiply it by its portfolio beta, and then divide it by the index value multiplied by 100 to calculate the number of contracts to purchase of XND. Now, let's take a look at the top three questions by investors for timing an effective portfolio hedge. Statistically, the probability of predicting a major market correction is quite low. Market corrections greater than 5% in a single month only happen about 12% of the time. That means when the market starts to correct, 88% of the time, that correction will be less than 5%. Instead, you should use these times to collect premiums such as selling cover calls and credit spreads that can be utilized to buy puts when it's actually necessary to buy puts. The best indicator to look at is to compare the 30-day and 90-day implied volatility of an index option in order to determine when the market is in a state of panic. When the 30-day implied volatility is higher than the 90-day, that typically means the market is in a state of distress and that panic has set in. These conditions generally necessitate a portfolio hedge. Look for volatility and momentum to diverge from price in order to identify a market bottom. For example, let's look at the February to March 2020 sell-off. The market bottomed on March 23rd. However, VolQ, the NASDAQ 100 volatility index, peaked on March 16th and diverged with price a full 7 days before the market bottom. Additionally, the momentum indicator, measured by CCI here, diverged from price a full 11 days before the market bottom. Use these indicators to help you understand when to close out a portfolio hedge. I hope that this was helpful in pointing you in the right direction with how to put on an effective portfolio hedge using index options. We'd love to hear from you, so please share with us your comments about your experiences of protecting your portfolio using various strategies. If you found this useful in helping you get started, don't forget to hit the subscribe button and the notification bell to receive alert updates when we upload the next video in this series. Thank you and happy trading.